morning. This video is brought to you by Sunco Transportation. More on that in just a second. We are blazing along Highway 5A and 97C, the connector highway. But we're not actually going to connect. We're staying on 5A. We're gonna turn off here in 4 kilometers and go south towards Princeton. So we're just south of Merritt right now on 5A, southeast. So yeah, Sutco is sponsoring me on this video. Sutco is hiring Class 1 flat deck drivers in British Columbia and Alberta. Go to sutco.ca to apply and use promo code QuanFam to receive an extra $100 on your first paycheck. There's also links down below in the description. And if you decide to call them, tell them you're a QuanFam. Let them know I sent you. You'll get some extra bucks on your payday. Oh, so, it is 12 degrees Celsius. Quite cloudy, a light drizzle here and there. I was hoping to go for a motorcycle ride this weekend, and that just did not work out. And then today's plan has been changed. Originally I was told we're headed for Holmdel, Idaho. And I think because I ran out of time and could not load on Friday, they gave me a shorter run. Still loaded in Barrier, north of Kamloops, hour north of Kamloops. But this one's going to Old Town, Idaho, and I can make that tonight. There for the load tomorrow morning. Seems squeaky. I think that's the squeaking of the hood. Not sure what else it would be. I've had that before. Might just have to open the hood and close it again. Get a new seat properly. That's okay. Jess isn't here, so it won't drive her absolutely nuts. She'll be back with us again next week. Next weekend is Monday, is a holiday in Canada, but Sutco's got deliveries headed to the US and they've asked me to do that. Load Friday, deliver Monday, which would mean I would get Saturday off, drive all of Sunday, so I said no. If I can load Thursday, have Friday and Saturday off, just have a regular 2-day weekend, okay, I'm in. Otherwise, I'm out. So they'll look into that, get back to me. This Saturday and next Saturday, and I need an additional day off to do chores, chopping and laundry and, you know, all that stuff. good that they call ahead and check with you and see if you're okay with stuff. I love that. Of course, the first thing they said is, if you have plans for Monday already, just let us know and we'll find a different driver to take this load. So, it's cool. It's nice working for a company that'll work with your schedule. Pretty rough. We'll see. This got paved a year or two ago, so further down the road we'll see how rough it gets. Dealership put up my dash cam up in the center up there. They put a bunch of tape on the back. We'll see if it sticks. But they put it in an awful place. Check where the wipers sweep. The wiper does not wipe that part of the windshield. Big V here where the wipers don't go with you. That camera, anytime it rains hard, or lots of bugs, or in the winter snow, you would have zero visibility. So I'm gonna leave it there. If it stays for the next week or so, once I can get a new mount, then we'll place it in a place where the camera is actually within the windshield. Signs at 90. This is a road that I have not recorded very often for you guys. It's been a long time, probably the first time in 4K. Beautiful two-lane highway. Pretty darn breezy out today, too. It's comfortable going outside with a short sleeve shirt, but it is breezy. My load's such a weird, awkward shape. I have struggled getting the tarp nice and snug. Moving out a little bit. Which I'm not a fan of doing, but I can throw some more straps over top of it if I want. But it's snug, it's not going anywhere, so it should be good. Bumpy and bouncy road, but so far the road's in really good conditions. We'll see it further down. No live stream this week. But likely Jess will be doing live streams on the other channel playing video games. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Lumber headed north. I've got lumber headed south. That was one by probably six. One by six. 45 kilometers till Princeton. This is the same load, same place I picked up a load a month ago where I twisted my ankle. My ankle's almost back to normal, still a little bit swollen, and it doesn't like twisting side to side. So sure enough, I walked on top of this load and I went across the whole load before even attempting rolling in the tarps. I just kind of felt the whole load. And there was a whole bunch of hidden voids. I grabbed a marker and I marked where the hidden voids were, and then went to tarp. Like, I am not twisting my ankle again. Anytime I go there to watch for voids, but they need to have a sticker on the side that says uneven load or marked on top of it where the voids are. Or at least talk to you before you get on top of the load and tell the driver, hey, there's voids on this lumber. Be careful where you step. Some kind of communication, they have to be careful. Now that I know it's there, it's not really a problem. I can look out for it. But it's underneath the lumber wrap, so you can't see there's a void. Got a feel for them. Light drizzle here. Now, last week we saw so much wildlife. We need Jasper more often just to be spotting all the wildlife. Haven't seen any yet today, other than deer. Nice little lake down there. up here. Down a bit to 11 degrees Celsius here. Another little lake, lots of little lakes down this road. Downgrade. there's a lake where normally there shouldn't be a lake. Middle of a pasture field. Celsius. Drop the temperature quick. There's a little bit of a dirt bike trail down there. And another dirt bike trail here, but it's underwater. Got some ramps and stuff. They're all under a lake. Some nice blue sky there, so maybe we'll have some nice warm weather coming up. I didn't look at the forecast, so Jess is usually on top of that. I think we're done for snow, unless there's a freak storm or something like that. Well, I guess I can't say that because over the weekend the snow line moved pretty low. This has got a really nice lake here. Bigger of a lake. Yet another lake, and this one's got a beautiful green to it, although I guess you guys can't see it all that well because of the angle. Right beside me, it's got that turquoise green look. Up ahead of us, you can't quite see it as well. Hey, dear. Another lumber truck, Super Bee. On the other side of this little lake. Must be a way of getting there. Kind of marshy here. motivation. Lots of deer out. Air horn usually works on deer. No other animals, but deer, the air horn usually motivates deer. Poor condition, but so far we're really good. Debris in the ditches all around some of these corners. Most of the debris looks like big rig debris. So this winter must not have been very nice to big rigs. Another one here. It's the third corner now. That was all windows. Third corner there with debris in the ditch. Because the Coquihalla was washed out. First half of this winter, Coquihalla was closed. This was the main route to get to Vancouver. A lot of people don't know this road, and it's not a very forgiving road. Basically, people coming from the north wanting to go to Vancouver had to come on Highway 5 to Merritt, come over here this way to Princeton and then take the Hope Princeton through Manning Park. Basically became a major trucker highway for a couple of months there. These roads are always the fun ones to take because they're the narrow, twisting, winding roads. Which I gotta work a lot harder. I really like them. Fun. Not boring. Something weird's happened to YouTube and our channel this year. You guys are still joining. Thank you. Getting a subscriber or two every single day. All the years I've been on YouTube, I would get subscribers in the winter, and then subscribers would stop. This winter we got a lot of subscribers, and it slowed right down now, but we're still getting one or two subscribers every day, so if you're new to the channel, thank you! Thanks for hitting that subscribe button. About 23% of you guys on watch are subscribed now, so I'm not complaining, that's pretty good. Lumber mill chatter. Very much ranch land over here. -15 degrees Celsius. Some blue to the right, some blue to the left. Guess where we're headed? Straight into the nut blue. Maybe by the time we get there, it's blown across. This highway is definitely a low traffic highway. Princeton Airport. Downgrade. Kettle Valley Rail Trail on our left hand side.
Stop leaving the bin.
Fire truck north on 5-8. One year, Jess and I quadded all the way from Summerland to here. Pulled into the gas station, fueled up, and then turned around and quadded all the way back. Well, they put in a light over here too. Oh, that is awesome. That is awesome. I knew they put a light in over here. I didn't realize they put a light on that corner. Man, that was needed a long time ago. You guys have seen plenty of times. So pretty good timing. Showed you guys a connector a couple of weeks ago. Now we're back on Highway 3. You guys have seen Highway 3 all the time, so got to see something new. Going tomorrow. Milkameen River is kind of just staying there. It's not really going up or down. Hopefully we can keep it there as the mountaintops start melting. It's warmer weather. It's 16 degrees here. It's definitely quieter and less entertaining without the guests. Now, for now, our plan is kind of every other week. She's got a whole bunch of stuff going on that we've got to make appointments and stuff for. But then maybe after July sometime, maybe she'll start doing longer than 1 week at a time. Taking up a whole hour of your day already. So thank you. Thank you for watching, subscribing, thumbs up, commenting. Especially commenting. The watch time and commenting is the best for me. That's always my highest. Yes, lots of comments. Linda's tried to overwhelm me with comments, but you guys are gonna have to help her out. So I read every single one of them. Reading the commenters that have lots of positive comments and also critique, constructive criticisms. I like a good mix. I think that makes us human, a good mix. I don't need every comment to be a how much you like my videos. Appreciate some of those. I also appreciate what you guys would have done differently. Just keep them human. Remember, we're all human. Respectful. Keep the comments respectful, friendly. We really do have a really good positive. Oh, it looks like they've fixed that seat can. The seat can is now sitting nice and level again. Kind of fix all the flooding damage along here. But yeah, really positive community. It's fun to see you guys all interacting with each other. I know for me it's been a lot of fun, so I am out of here. See you guys tomorrow. You guys rock.
Yeah, the only thing that's left is the numbers on the side, 127. Don't think you'll get that back in service too soon.
bike, or you're still sitting there?
Oh, I'm behind the train here. He let everybody else out before he let us go.
Okay.
Once you get past the fire, there's lots of three lane up to work your way up. Yeah. You want them with a nicely sharp load?
Hey, what was that?
Is that one with a nicely tarp load there?
It is.
Looking good there. Whenever I drive, I always look like a three-year-old wrapping a Christmas present.
Yeah, it's a little bit of work with a funny shape, but it worked.
Yeah, then well, where are you off to with that?
It's going to Old Town, Idaho.
That didn't work. What a surprise. Have a good one. You going down to the Soyuz and crossing over 20?
Yeah, taking 20 through Republic and Kettle.
And then the shortest way there is the Flowery Trail, is the quickest. Just got to Tooele, head up over the hill, brings you down to Austin.
Yeah.
Much faster, but it's a little bit faster, close traffic, and nice drive.
Very cool, you're starting to break up, so have a good day.
You too, Juan.
So that's a burnt down.
Yeah, that poor truck. Even the wrecker is not even salvageable on it. That whole thing is right off.
Burnt down tow truck. Jamie Davis, tow truck. 127, I think. Wasn't expecting that on Richter Pass over here. No camera crew though, too far away from home base. Soyuz down there. Figure I'll throw the extra clip in the back over here. Don't see that every day.